So, I was thinking, can standalone Battle Royale games and Hunger Games types of games actually work on their own as standalone titles? And what do they need? Let's try to figure that out. Welcome back, my dear friends of the universe. Today we are going to talk about what I talked about in the beginning of this video. We're going to talk about standalone Battle Royale games and standalone Hunger Games types of games. And what makes me qualified to talk about this, especially if you're new to my channel, you may be asking yourself this question. Well, I've been published in numerous gaming journalist pages when it comes to this, especially in 1962. I don't think there's actually anything like that, to be honest. But I have played hundreds upon hundreds of hours of these types of mods and modes and games. And the first thing that I want to address about this and why I sort of got this little thought in the beginning and why I'm asking myself if this is really going to work as a standalone game is that these types of like Battle Royale or Hunger Games types of games, like for Ark Survival Evolved, I would say that more resembles Hunger Games, the Survival of the Fittest mode, than it does Battle Royale. But these modes were mods from the beginning. See what they're there? And the first one that I played was probably for Arma 2, and then we had the one for Arma 3, we have King of the Kill now, and we have the Culling as standalone titles, and we have a Battle Royale mod for Rust, and there's a lot of mods that are Battle Royale for different kinds of games, but that is the thing, they are mods. They are something that has been added into a game that offers a lot more than just this mod. And when you offer this as a standalone title, I think it could be a little bit too thin, barebone, sort of, maybe. As much as I love these types of games, when you play them for a couple of hours, you usually get a little bit bored. It's almost always the same thing over and over again. And when it comes to the other games like Arma or Rust, I usually end up trying to play some sort of other mod or mode to actually just, I don't know, get some variety into it. And that's why I think if you're gonna make this a standalone title and actually have a pretty good price tag on it and actually be able to make some sort of money on it, you have to flesh it out a little bit more. And there's some blaring issues when it comes to this mod. One of the biggest ones, I think, is for new players when it comes to this, because it's very hard to get into this and actually feel like you're getting rewarded and you're learning something, because it's very punishing usually. And I would say that someone getting into one of these mods or games probably would have to play like 10 or 15 games before they get some sort of hang on what they need to do, and then work from there and get more and more advanced. But those, you have to actually sacrifice a lot of time there in the beginning to become better and actually learn the mechanics and actually try to or even accomplish anything, really. So I think there's a huge boundary, a huge threshold that you need to try to pass and get over in order to get in there and actually enjoy these games. So one thing that I think is very important is when you try to release a standalone titles like The Culling or King of the Kill, then maybe think about different modes. Of course, the Battle Royale or the Hunger Games mode is going to be the bread and butter of the game, the core of the game, the main mode. Probably a mode that has some sort of ranking or ladder system to actually be something that people feel like they are progressing through. I think we have seen more and more like you get skins and so on, but I think these kinds of rewards are a little bit, in my opinion, a little bit, okay, it's fun. It's fun with skins. It's fun to get new apparel, cool stuff that you can use for your character to look as badass as you want. But I think there needs to be something more, some sort of progression system, maybe a profile leveling system, some sort of rankings or some sort of ladders or some sort of competitive edge or something that makes these a little bit more interesting to try to play in the long run. Because I think there's an issue there. But when it comes to game modes that I think that could be added, I mean, this would be pretty easy, in my opinion, to add something to. Like for The Culling, for example, they could add standard deathmatch, or team deathmatch, or gun game. I think gun game is an excellent mode in order to learn as much of how the game mechanics works in terms of the actual battle as possible. I think for any game that offers gun game, the first game that mode that I'm actually trying to go into is gun game, just because that you have to get kills with every gun. So you sort of need to learn every single gun in the game. Almost, they usually don't incorporate it in every single gun, but almost. So that gets you a feel of how the shooting mechanics is built and the mechanics of the games. And standard deathmatch or team deathmatch or something like that could be a great way to bridge that gap for new players in order to actually start enjoying and learning faster how to get into the main mode of the game. And I think that is an important one. I think there needs to be more variety when it comes to these. Now, most of these games, or like, for example, Arma 2 or Arma 3, they have very varied maps in the game itself and for different other mods, and a lot of people try to use these different maps in order to create some sort of variety when it comes to the mode itself, and I think that is very important. Now, I understand the importance of having one really good map where you balance it and it feels good for everybody to play on, but I think there still needs to be some sort of variety in there to make it more interesting in the long run, at least for people like me. I gotta say, now that I'm getting older, doing the same thing over and over and over again gets boring for me. It's not something that, like, when I was a kid, that wasn't an issue. I could play the same stuff over and over for months at a time. Like, I don't know, I played Counter-Strike for hundreds upon hundreds of hours, doing the same thing, playing public servers and so on. So, but I think that if you actually want to get your customers coming back and be interested in this product in the long run, I think there needs to be more to the game than just this basic mode. If not, it needs to be something very special and very fleshed out. You need to cater to a lot of different playstyles for these kinds of games to be enjoyable. I think, for example, H1Z1 King of the Kill is a little bit too focused on only the gunplay. Of course, there's going to be strategy and placement, and you have to use the environment against your opponents in order to get a sneaky approach and maybe take them out before they even see you. But the Culling is doing this a little bit better, in my opinion. They have traps, they have very good melee combat systems, they have ranged combat systems, and more and more and more. So the Culling is doing it better, in my opinion, but these kinds of games are taking a very different approach. H1Z1, King of the Kill, for example, have very short time to kill. It's very unforgiving, especially if you're a new player. And when it comes to the Culling, you can be a little bit smarter, because you won't get it taken out with at least, or like, one. Maybe if you have some really good explosives, you might be able to take someone out in one bang. But I haven't noticed that. Usually when I get hit by explosives, I get like 10 or 20 HP left. So there is that with the Culling, that they have the longer time to kill, which makes a more dynamic gameplay in terms of how you want to approach the different things and how you want to play. If you want to play like more like a strategist, then that is a very valid option. Or you can try to go more like, oh, I'm the MLG pro, I'm gonna shoot headshots all day long, and that might work for some people. Some people have great aim and can head someone's head all the time, so that might work for them, but I don't think that is a playstyle that should be something that everyone has to adapt to. And when it comes to H1Z1 and these other types of games, it's a little bit more unforgiving, and it's a little bit less that you can do with these mods in order to make them feel more fleshed out and fun to play in the long run. Now, I've been thinking about this. I think the Culling is doing something very interesting with having these kinds of perks. I'm not sure if you play the game, but if you haven't played the game, they have these kinds of perks that gives you varied benefits in the actual game. Like maybe, for example, you do more damage with spears from backstabs, or maybe you run a little faster, or maybe you do a little bit more damage with every weapon, and so on and so forth. But I think this could be taken to another level, something that could be a really interesting thing when it comes to team play, when it comes to like the competitive scene, is something that I personally would quite enjoy if it's done right. And that instead of having perks, then maybe have like characters or heroes or gods or whatever you want to call them, try to merge this with some sort of MOBA. I was thinking about this, and there's of course some blatant issues with this idea, because there's going to be permadeath, and if you're playing in a team, that can make you or place you in a very bad situation. But I still think there's something very interesting there. Instead of having perks, you have these kinds of different heroes or characters that have different benefits. Like one, for example, might be better at sniping, one might be better at sneaking, one might be better at just rushing somebody head on and trying to take them out, or somebody might be better at just taking punishment because they're really fat or something like that. I think that could be an interesting dynamic gameplay, even for the standalone or the lone player, the lone wolf as well. But I think maybe focus a little bit more on the team play aspect to make this a little bit more interesting in the long run, especially when it comes to actually watching these games. And I think that's a big part of gaming overall, especially when it comes to some sort of competitive gaming. And these modes are very competitive. I mean, everyone in the round is trying to compete in order to get that number one spot. So it is very competitive, and if done right, I think this could be very enjoyable to watch and something that could be very popular as well. I think this is a mode that is very easy to understand, especially since we have movies like Hunger Games and so on. So people have something to relate to that they don't really have, like with the Counter-Strike and so on. So I could, this could be very interesting when it comes to that. And something that I wanted to talk about as well is that it would be interesting to have more varieties when it comes to map. I already mentioned this, but I was thinking more like different kinds of levels. Now, we have seen verticality, and we have seen hills, and we have seen different buildings and so on. It's not something new when it comes to these, and I think that's a great thing. I think the dynamic maps actually opens up for very interesting encounters and something that you can use against your enemy, trying to take a high vantage point in order to take someone down in a valley out. I think that it creates interesting gameplay mechanics, but I think this could be worked on even more. My general idea was to have some sort of vast open map, and then you had different entry points to get in some sort of complex that was underground, a couple of levels underground, and then you work your way towards the center of this complex, and somewhere down below there may be more, a couple of different entries to this core place where the last stand is going to be, and there's a lot of different doors, and at a certain time point in the game these doors open so people can run in and try to fortify this location and so on. I think there you can do a lot more when it comes to the dynamics of the maps and the verticality and so on. I think there's a lot of things to be done there that could be really interesting when it comes to these games that I think are currently missed opportunities. But maybe I'm wrong about that. Maybe that just makes everything a little bit more too complicated. And one thing that we have seen in almost all of these kind of mods or modes or standalone games or whatever is airdrops. I don't know where this idea came from at first, but it does create certain opportunities or certain situations where people have to combat over this good loot in order to get an edge over everybody else. And it could potentially be interesting, but I think that especially sometimes when these kinds of airdrops land, and maybe there's only one player close to the area and he has a very easy time to get to these airdrops and try to get there quickly and actually get the loot that is inside, and he can get a very huge competitive edge over everybody else. And I think that could become a little bit unfair. I don't know, I think there should be other ways to rewarding the player. Now, in Ark Survival Evolved's Survival of the Fittest mode, we have something that is quite interesting when it comes to like challenges, or there's like different things that happens during the game. Like, for example, every dinosaur will attack you, even the herbivores. That was hard to say for some reason. I don't really know why. And there's like different modes where you can't see shit in front of you, and I think these kinds of challenges that appear for everyone is a little bit more interesting. I think something that you could work with instead of airdrops is maybe have like challenges in the matches, like some sort of mini game that gives the player that completes that certain task some sort of edge. And I think there's different things that you can do here instead of just reusing the airdrop thing over and over and over. I think it works, but for me, as someone who has played these kinds of mods for a very long time and have put hundreds upon hundreds of hours into these kinds of games, I think it is it's becoming a little bit too repetitive, and I would like to see something new and something that we haven't really seen before that could be interesting. And I think some sort of challenges along the way will keep the player entertained for a longer period of time. Maybe these challenges give you something outside of the game. Maybe they give you like an experience boost, or they give you some sort of skins that you can use for these other characters. I'm going to talk about characters and not perks and your own character, like heroes, for example, because I still think that idea could be really cool if done right. I do understand that there's some issues about that idea and that it could be hard to actually pull off, but I still think it's going to be pretty cool. And the last but not least thing that I think we should talk about, which I think is very important, is what kind of theme works for these kinds of games. Now, we have seen a lot of different themes. We have seen like more fantasy, sci-fi-esque themes with Survival of the Fittest. We have seen military sim themes with Arma and I guess you can say H1Z1 is a little bit more military, or I don't know, guerrilla combat or some sort of urban combat situations. I don't know. I think the Culling is doing a very nice and innovative approach to this to make the time to kill a little bit longer, and therefore creating opportunities for players that get jumped by other players, time to actually escape, and it creates a dynamic gameplay that is quite interesting. But I think these kinds of different options is something that you always have to weigh. Do we want it a little bit more unforgiving? Do we want that short time to kill? Or do we want something like the Culling, where it takes a little bit longer to kill, but and you have to be consistent with how you actually approach your enemy and try to damage them, and that way make it, I don't know, a little bit more interesting. But I was thinking what kind of themes works best. Like, if you, for example, want to make something like the Culling, or something that where you have to damage somebody a lot more than you would in a, like a military sim shooter, then something like sci-fi probably would work better. And one idea was that something medieval, something historical, something a little, maybe a little bit fantasy, or maybe just straight up historical, could be something really cool when it comes to this. Maybe you can play as a heavy knight, maybe you can play as a quick archer, maybe you can play as something in between, maybe you can play like as a some sort of mage kind of dude. Think chivalry, for example, but in a battle royale kind of setting. I think that could be really cool. So that's almost all I want to talk about this video. So if we're gonna summarize what we talked about, we are, I think there needs to be something that makes it easier for new players to get in. Maybe work with more levels, dynamics in the map, ladders and rankings could be really cool. Merging MOBAs and battle royale, think about that. Think about that. Heroes, characters, what kind of theme? Tell me what kind of theme you would like to see in these kinds of games. What would you think would work best? Leave me a comment below and we can discuss that, and you can give your own opinion of what would work for these kinds of games. This is still a genre that is very new and very much growing. Very much growing, and something that I think is very interesting, and something that we will see great concepts come out of the near future. I don't know. I love it. And I hope you do too, and I hope we can see something great come out of this in the future. Yeah. Thanks for watching and listening to me ramble about this stuff for a while. Like or dislike if you didn't like this, or like if you liked it, and please share if you liked it. And until next time. Bye. Beautiful time.